Yeah, hi everyone. So last week we fell into a little bit of a rabbit hole when I started talking about different ways we can improve neural network training and the generalization performance. Of course, we can't cover all the topics I outlined on that mind map. However, I think there are a few important ones that are really worth talking about. So in this lecture, I want to talk about batch normalization and also a little bit about different weight initialization schemes, which are also kind of important to make neural networks work well in practice. And then in the next lecture, I want to briefly talk about optimization algorithms. And then, yeah, we will move on and talk about cooler things like convolutional networks and recurrent neural networks. But for now, let's talk about batch normalization, because that's really a good technique for making the network train better and faster. All right, yeah, just to recap again, today we are talking about tricks for improving deep neural network training. So today in particular, we will talk about feature and input normalization and focus on a topic called batch norm. And then I will also talk about weight initialization schemes when we initialize the model weights. And there are two particular techniques we are going to take a look at. There's the Xavier-Glorot initialization scheme and the Kaeming-He initialization scheme. And then in the next lecture, we will talk about optimization algorithms for improving gradient descent learning. For instance, there's RMSProp, Adagrad, Adam, and I will also provide you with a list of many, many more algorithms. But yeah, personally, I think a stochastic gradient descent with momentum and Adam are still the most useful, or at least most popular ones. All right, so as an overview, things we are going to cover today. So I structured it into 7 parts. Some of these parts will be very short, but I try to structure it as always so that they go by topic and that it is somewhat organized. So first we will just briefly talk about input normalization. Then we will switch to batch normalization. I will show you how we do batch normalization in PyTorch. And then we will have a discussion of how or why batch normalization works. So I will explain here how it works, like the techniques or the procedure, and then we will revisit this here and discuss why it may have a positive effect in practice. So it's still a controversial topic, so it's still not clear, and I will highlight some of the theories. Then we will switch topics in this section here and talk about these different weight initialization schemes, like why we care about that, to different examples, and then also how it works in Python. All right, so with that, let's get started with input normalization.